She has no makeup on, her hair's not done. What could this video possibly be? Today we're gonna be filming a Get Ready With Me transformation. It's just not really transformation, it's just me getting ready. I thought this would be a great video to do because one, I didn't know what to film today and I'm trying to get better at this filming once a week type of thing. And two, I thought, you know, it'd just be fun, kind of informative. I'll tell you the products I use and what I do on the regular basis and just kind of fill you in tidbits of my life, I guess. So let's just go ahead and get started with this video. So I am sitting on the floor. That means I am about to do my hair. Every morning when I wake up, honestly, it's like 3 o'clock in the afternoon, so it's not morning. But in the morning when I wake up to get ready for work, I like brush my teeth, wash my face, and then I start with my hair first. And so we are just going to do the regular. So you should just split it kind of in half. And then I don't really do anything with the section. Like I just start curling it. I have the Hot Tools Professional wand. It has a little clampy thing, but I don't use the clamp. The reason I like this wand in particular is because it turns off in 2 hours if you forget and you leave it on. As a gal that does not want to burn down her house, her apartment, her roommate's stuff, this is very handy. Before I had this, I used to literally text my old roommate, be like, hey, can you check if I turned the curling iron off? And it's really annoying. And so I decided this was the best invention ever. And so that's literally all I do. If I see like a weird piece, I'll like do it real quickly too. So I just use this curling iron. It's not that special. And I'm just gonna go along my whole head and just curl it like I typically do. I usually will turn on a YouTube video and it like lasts like a 10-minute YouTube video and I'll curl my hair in the time that video is over or like start a new video. Or I will listen to a podcast. I'm listening to a pretty basic podcast. I'm pretty obsessed with Alicia and Remy. If you guys didn't know, I've been referencing them for like ever on my YouTube channel. And so I always wait till the weekend to listen to them because they make me just really excited. Someone else I listen to is Katie Bellotti. I actually met her when I went to New York. I've never seen her YouTube channel, but I visited my friend Shelby in New York and we just so happened to run across Katie Bellotti, just ironically, and I didn't want to go up to her because I didn't want to be that girl. And then I was like, you know what, if I don't do this one, I think I'm gonna like be really upset with myself, just because the only reason I wouldn't go up to her is because I was nervous. Two, I was like, she seems really nice in her podcast, like a very like personable person. Our personalities seem like it's very similar because I think she's kind of emotional and like, so am I. And back to the story of me walking up to her, we actually like saw her, we like passed her and we're like, wait, is that her? And then like we went to continue on shopping and then I like thought about it, I was like, I have to go see her. And so like I asked Shelby if she'd walk past her with me again. And so then like we walked past her again and I was like, excuse me, are you Katie? And oh, this is what I was saying. I was like, if I wasn't her, she's like, if one of you guys saw me in public, I would want you guys to come up to me 100% because like that is so cool. My point is that I went up to her and I said hello and I was really nervous and awkward and she took a picture with me. And that's my story, that's about it. So I just did one side of my hair. This is what it looks like. And the way I usually do this right here is I split it up into 3 sections just because the way my part is, I have more hair on this side. So I just put it up like this and then I grab a clip, have a clip right here. I'm gonna clip it up and just finish curling the side of my hair. And just like that, it is all curled. Literally from the time I started this camera to now, it's been 8 minutes. So it's really quick, but I learned a trick on my straightening iron. So I'm gonna plug this up. It is the GHD. I've had this for like probably over 5 years. Have I? I think so. But you just turn it on, it makes this beep sound, and then it like literally just heats up in 30 seconds. It'll beep again, and it turns off by itself. Okay, so it's done heating up. But basically, I learned a really cool trick from my hair salon. The people there are amazing. Amelia does my hair. I love you, Amelia. Thank you so much for doing my hair. Changed my hair. But basically, what I learned is that they would use a straightening iron and they would make curls through and then the bottoms would be straight. And I don't really know how to curl my hair with a straightening iron. Like, I'm not that good. But what I can do is straighten the ends of my hair with a straightening iron like this, and it gives it like this really cool wavy look. I don't know, I just think it's like a new like thing. Maybe it's not something I just started doing and I like how my hair looks with it and it makes my hair look longer when I do it. So I'm just going to do this. I don't do this every morning when I'm going to work or when I'm going out just because I do feel like it's a lot of heat on my hair, but if I have a little extra time, I definitely will because I like how it looks. I'm gonna do this side too. And that's it, that's how it looks. So turn this off. Now lastly, if I really feel like it, and again, I don't always do this with my hair, some Living Proof Nourishing Style Cream. I got this in that FabFitFun box and I've actually really, really liked it. So just take a tiny, tiny bit and then just like put it in my hair. This stuff doesn't make me feel like I have product in my hair, which is why I like it. But that's literally how I do my hair every single day. Let's go ahead and do the makeup. I'm like sort of angling myself in a different way than I typically do my makeup, so this is gonna be kind of weird. But here we are, hello. Let me grab my makeup. Currently, the way I organize everything is this little container that I got from the Container Store. It just divides it. I would keep this in my drawers, but plot twist, it doesn't fit. So I'm gonna put this on my desk right here and get ready like I normally do. I'm gonna zoom in. Hi everyone. And I'm also sitting on a pillow and it's poking me. This hurts, ow, okay. So basically for the primer that I've been using lately is the Milk Hydro Grip Primer Base Adhesive. I got this out of a recommendation. So far, I like it, no issues. Put that all over my face. I don't have the best skin, but it's definitely better than what it used to be. Last year, my skin just freaked out. And so I'm working really, really hard on clearing it. I'm going to use a little bit of the Marc Jacobs foundation. I literally just kind of concentrate it on my cheeks because that's where my acne scars are the worst. And I use just a tiny bit of that, and then I use one pump of the Becca Ultimate Coverage foundation. And I'm going to use this brush because I have it, but it is the sculpting brush from Real Techniques. And so I literally just do one pump of that. Really weird to be sitting in silence and doing my makeup. TBH. Also, I feel like this light is making it worse. Hold on. I don't know if this is better, but I moved the ring light over here and it's really hot in my room, so that's great. Summer. Okay, so I just basically put this on as evenly as I can. I found this foundation mix just helps me cover up all the scars that I want to cover up. But now we're going to use the Kat Von D Contour Palette. As you can see, I've used this so much. Oh, hello. And I'm just going to basically contour my face. So I'm just gonna use the middle color, just you know, contour. I feel like I want to film another video where I kind of give you guys a life update, but I think it'd be best to do that around my birthday because that's really, you know, it's from January and then to like July. And I can just kind of tell you guys where my life's at because someone commented on that video a few weeks ago and it had me check it and like watch it. And I was like, wow, my life's kind of different. And I think that it'd be really helpful to do just like a little life update video. And so I don't want to talk too much about what's going on. Honestly, there's not much going on in my life, but I don't want to like talk about everything right now in this video, which is why I'm like a little quiet. But I think it'd be an interesting video and it's something that I kind of want to film, if not for you guys, at least for myself, so I can look back at it. Okay, so now I'm gonna put on some blush. I've had this blush literally for years. It's called Desert Rose and it's from MAC. And so just gonna put a little bit of blush on. And a lot of my brushes are either Real Techniques or Sigma brushes. And now I'm going to put a little bit of highlight on. This is Spoon. It is from ColourPop. I love ColourPop's highlighters, which is why I'm always hitting pan in them. But just the top of the cheekbone. If you watch my old Get Ready With Me videos, I feel like not much has changed in like my makeup. Maybe the products, but my techniques are the same, I feel like. I don't really know. This is just me getting ready on a regular basis. Becca Moonstone Mini Highlighter. Now I'm gonna do my eyebrows. I'm using a ColourPop pot. And it's not my favorite, to be honest. I usually prefer a pencil, but I don't have a pencil. And I'm trying to save some money, so we're just gonna use this. I don't even think I'm that good at my makeup. I just kind of like doing it. One thing that I firmly believe is that makeup is there to help you feel good, for you to play around with. It's artistic, but I don't think people should depend on makeup. I think it's really cool and fun to challenge yourself and be like, I don't gotta wear makeup today. At work, personally, I do prefer to wear makeup just because I feel like it makes me my most confident self. But when I'm running errands and stuff, I do try to challenge myself not to wear makeup as much, just so that way I can remind myself that I don't need it to feel good about myself. I don't really know if that helps or if that's like mumbo jumbo, but I personally believe it. So I think that you guys should all remember that you're beautiful just the way you are. Sometimes, not always, I will use the 3D brow tones from Benefit. I love all of Benefit's brow items. TBH, would recommend. I use ColourPop because I think it is just as good and it's cheaper. I'm always here for them deals. I'm going to use Millionaire by ColourPop just as a base color. Set. ColourPop. Wow. I'm going to use Stardust. It's one of my favorites. I think it's a really beautiful copper color. And then for the crease, I'm going to use the Huda Beauty Coral Obsessions palette, and I'm going to use this middle shade right here just because I want to do kind of something simple for the eyes, nothing crazy. And I think I'm going to use this color at the very, very top, or I guess it'd be the bottom in your case, right here. I just kind of play around with eyeshadows. I don't really have an idea what I'm going to do until it kind of just gets done. Again, I don't really know what I'm doing half the time, so hello. And use Mooney. Is it Mooney or Money? Mooney. At the very bottom, just as like a little eyebrow highlight color. And now I'm going to use this right here. It is the Fenty eyeliner. It's called Flyliner. And I'm just going to line my lids. Gotta focus. I don't think I'll ever be that girl that knows how to make winged eyeliners. Wings, like I just can't. I'm using the Milk Kush mascara. And so I learned this one's really good for the top, but not the bottom. So I usually do different mascara for the top and bottom. For bottom, I'm going to use the Marc Jacobs, what is this? The Major Volume Mascara. Okay, so now I'm going to set my face. This is the Hangover Too Faced one. This is a mini sample. I am not obsessed with it, but I like how it smells and I got it as a sample before. And so I'm just going to spray my face with this. I usually literally lean back in my chair and just spray away. Just kind of fan it, and at this point, this is where I go put on deodorant in my body, so actually, I'm gonna go ahead and do that. It was in this moment I realized that you guys might actually care about what I use on my body. So for deodorant, I use the Ban regular roll-on. I prefer this one just because I like how it dries quickly and it doesn't leave any like white residue or any type of residue. I prefer this one. I think it does the trick. And then I'm using the OG Pink Sweet and Flirty. It is time to set the face with some powder. I used to use the Laura Mercier setting powder, and I really do like it. I really do prefer it, but I decided I was going to try out a dupe, and it's the Airspun Loose Face Powder. I got this literally from Walmart, and there's so much of it, and it was cheap, and so I decided we're going to try it, because if it's just face powder and it does the same thing, then why not? As you can see, it goes everywhere. I try to focus it under my eyes, just because I know that's where a lot of my makeup creases. And then I just take a little bit and just kind of put all over my face, wherever kind of seems a little extra shiny. Last step, the lipstick. Again, just like eyeshadows, lips literally change every single day. It's a nude lipstick by Pure Minerals. It literally says nude lipstick. This was a sample I got forever and ever ago, but I really like the color. So we're just gonna use this on the lips. We're going to put a little gloss over it. This is the Gel Gloss Ultra Brilliant in Perfect Nude from Sephora. And voila, the makeup is done. Okay, so I'm gonna set the camera over there so you get a whole lot of more like natural lighting, and then we can kind of give you like the full hair and makeup. And just like that, we are done. You can see I have my ring light over here. I need to put it away. And I kind of cleaned up the back, but I finished getting ready. I am just wearing the Dalmatian shorts I got in my last runway haul. I decided to change into a black tank top, and then I put on a denim jacket over it. For jewelry, we got some big silver hoops, and then for shoes, we have these right here. They're like little gladiator type of sandals. I got them from TJ Maxx. No. I got them from Payless or Target. So I've had these for like 3 years, and this is what they look like. And yeah, that's basically it. Let me know if you guys would be interested in a get ready with me when I go to work video, because it's basically the same process, but like a little different. You will get to see my face as soon as I get out of the bed, and I don't know if you want to see that. So let me know if you're interested in that in the comments down below. Let me know if you like this video. I know it was a little wonky and just kind of all over the place, but I don't know, it's kind of fun to film. So let me know your opinion about that. If you like it, give it a big thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, and hit that bell icon notification button, because I'm trying my best to upload a video every single week, and I want to make sure you get notified when I do. But that is about it. I will see you guys next time. Bye.